my official New Year's Eve makeup tutorial. I know this is coming like really last minute, but this of course does not have to just be worn on New Year's Eve. This can be worn all year round, like any look, it's just makeup. I would definitely recommend this for a girl's night out or a weekend look, or going to a party, or Monday afternoon to get lunch, like whatever you please. So I am super excited because not only is this my favorite look that I've ever done, like I'm not kidding. Ooh, this is seriously my favorite look I've ever done here at my YouTube, but it's cool tones, which is amazing. I tweeted just a couple days ago that my New Year's resolution is that I want to start wearing more cool tone colors, which I was partially kidding, but totally serious at the same time, you know? I've already started buying like silver accessories because I'm like, okay, this year I'm going to start wearing more silver. I'm going to start wearing more cool tone blushes, more cool tone eyeshadows. I'm such a warm person. Like the way I dress and do my makeup and my hair, everything is warm. But it's funny because my house and like my home decor is all silvers and grays and whites. But yet like me, I'm always like golds and burgundies and oranges. So I want to start wearing more cool tones to kind of round myself out as a human being. So yeah, that is just like my silly little side note of a New Year's resolution. I also have a personal resolution as well, which is going to be, I want to try to not be as hard on myself in the year of 2015. I am very, very, extremely hard on myself to the point that everyone in my life is always telling me like, knock it off, Jacqueline, stop being so hard on yourself, it's ridiculous. And so this year, I'm gonna really try to make a conscious effort to stop being so hard on myself and just let myself breathe and let myself relax and just like admit to myself like everything is gonna be okay, you're not ever gonna be perfect, and that is just fine. So that is my personal New Year's resolution. I would love it if you guys would share with me your resolutions, even if they're silly or funny or quirky or makeup related or if they're personal. I love it when you guys open up to me. I love it when you just interact with me. So let me know your New Year's resolution. I would absolutely love that. I'm gonna stop rambling and get into the video now. Just a little side note though. Thank you so much to all of you who have stuck around, who have been riding with me for this entire year, or even if you just joined me last week, or if this is your first video. Thank you so much for being part of my life in 2014. I am so excited for 2015. The best is yet to come. I am so excited and anxious at the same time. I have so many things planned for 2015, and I hope it's the best year of my life, and I also hope it's the best year of your life. So just remember to keep a positive attitude, even when things just seem black all around you. Just remember to see the light, see the silver lining, and just keep a positive outlook on life. It will do you wonders. So thank you so much for being with me. Thank you so much for watching this video. I love you guys, and I'll see you next year. Bye.
Okay, let's do this. My eyes are already primed, and I'm gonna start off with Makeup Geek Barcelona Beach, which is just a great cool tone brown, perfect for the transition color in our crease. I'm using an E40 brush by Sigma to blend this back and forth, and I'm putting this pretty much all over the lid, but I'm not taking it too far into the inner corner. Then I'm gonna go in with M620, which is a dark, very pigmented gray shadow by Makeup Forever. I'm using an E25 brush from Sigma to put this only on the outer corner. I'm literally going to just put the tiniest amount in the outer corner and then just focus on blending that outward. Because this is so intensely pigmented, I don't want the outer corner of my eye to be super intense because I don't want the top to really be super smoky. So I'm just putting it in the outer corner and then blending it out. If you go back in with a little bit more Barcelona Beach on your brush, that will really help out the blending process, which is what I'm doing right now. I have a little bit more of that color, and I'm just going to go back and forth and blend everything out and put a little bit of that Barcelona Beach on the lid as well, as you can see me doing, just to kind of smooth everything over so that nothing is too harsh. Then I'm going to go in and do my eyeliner. I'm using Maybelline Gel Eyeliner in Black is Black. This has been one of my favorite eyeliners forever. And I am going to do my eyeliner the same as I always do. So I start on the outer corner. I make a line from the outer corner of my eye up at an angle towards the tail of my brow, and then I take that line all the way until my inner corner, and then I literally just fill it in, as you can see me doing here. I've been doing my liner like this for quite some time, and I absolutely love it. If you guys would like a detailed tutorial on it, let me know, but I kind of always try to show you guys how I do it in my videos. I think it is the easiest way to do it. So I'm just going back and forth, really blackening them up and evening them out. That way they look symmetrical. Now for the fun part, I'm going to be going in with Lit Cosmetics Loose Glitter in the shade Cher. Oh my gosh, this is the perfect New Year's Eve glitter. It's like a clear crystal glitter with reflex of like blues and purples. Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous. I'm going to be using the Lit Cosmetics Glitter Adhesive as well. So I just wet my brush. This is the same brush that is sold on their website. I think it is the best for this. And then I will dip that brush right after dipping it in the base. I will dip it into the glitter and then I will just go on with my bad self and line the top of that liner. Now, this is not going to be easy peasy. Of course, you're gonna be like, ah, I made a mistake, I messed up. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not gonna be like a smooth ride. My right eye, as you can see, I was pretty pleased. It was so smooth, easy sailing. But now my left eye, because I'm right-handed, it made it a little bit more tricky. So I'm going to show you how I messed up and how I fixed my mistakes. That way, if you guys kind of make the same mistakes as me, you guys can fix them as well. So you can see here that it got kind of sloppy, and then I got a chunk of glitter all over my liner. All I'm going to do is go back with that exact same liner brush. This is the E65 from Sigma, and I'm going to take a generous amount of that black gel liner that we had in the first place, and all I'm going to do is go over that liner and just remove and cover up that glitter, and you will see how it's going to go from choppy to completely smooth again. So just take a generous amount of that liner and clean that bad boy up so that you have nice, crisp, flawless edges again, as you can see right here. So then I'm going to go in and just coat my upper lashes with mascara. It does not matter what mascara you use because we're going to be putting false lashes right on top of it. So any mascara will do. Today I'm going to be going in with Velour Lashes in the style Lash in the City. These are very full, very fluffy, and the outer corner of them has like a little bit of like a flick, like a little wing, just to kind of accentuate that, you know, liner, cat eye, wing situation that we have going on. And you can see the way that looks. And I always have to do an interpretive dance after I apply my first lash because it just feels so satisfying, like, yes, one eye complete. So I'm just gonna pop on the other one, and then I'm going to go over the base of that lash and cover up with gel liner. I make sure that I do this every single time I put on false lashes because it'll just make it so that when you look down, people aren't like, oh, hello, false lash. So today I am going to be using a new primer. This is by Chanel. This is the Sheer Illuminating Base Primer. I've been on a primer kick recently and I've been trying out so many, and so I'm trying out this one right now. I must say, so far, loving. Typical, right? Of course, the primer that costs an arm and a leg, you have to like sell your soul for, is the one I love. And then I'm gonna go in with NARS. I believe this is the Pro Line and Pore Filler, and I'm going to be putting this on the areas of my face where my foundation tends to crease, because let's get real, I like to make a lot of facial expressions throughout my day. So I'm going to put it around my lips, in between my eyebrows, and on my forehead. Then I'm going to go in with Makeup Forever HD Foundation. I am in shade 123. Well, technically, my face is probably like a shade 0 or negative 0, negative 1. But my neck is shade number 123, and I'm matching my face to my neck. If I were to match my foundation to my face in the color that that is, that would not look cute. So I always recommend matching your foundation to your neck or your forearm, something that is not just your face, because if you just match your foundation to your face, sometimes your body is a different color and then it just looks very awkward and uneven. So I always recommend matching your foundation to your body. I am using F80 foundation brush from Sigma, kicking it old school. This is still one of my all-time favorite foundation brushes. You can't go wrong with it. It's so great and it blends everything out so fast. Then I'm going to go in and conceal my under eye the same way that I always do. I'm using MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NW25, I believe. And I'm going to just buff that out with a damp beauty blender. I always take my concealer down in a V motion up towards my temples. The reason to do this is because it will just give your face a little bit of a lifted, more sculpted look. Then I'm going to go in and set everything. I'm going to mix Anastasia Banana Powder and MAC Pro Emphasize. This is a shaping powder. I'm gonna mix these two together and then set my under eye concealer. And this will give a little bit more of a highlight, not too much though, but I have to set my concealer or I am a creasy mess no matter what. This is a must for me. Then to even out that highlight, I'm gonna put a little bit of it on my chin, my Cupid's bow, little bit on the nose, and then a little bit on the forehead as well. I always recommend spreading out your highlight on the high points of your face, because if you just do it underneath your eyes, sometimes it can be kind of like, whoa, what happened? Then I'm going to go in and fill in my brows. I'm doing my brows a little bit differently than I did when I did my most recent updated brow routine. I am using the shade Ash Blonde, which is weird, I know, because I have red hair and I'm definitely not blonde, but I'm using Ash Blonde and Chocolate. I kind of mix those two together, and I specifically use the shade Chocolate on the outer tail of my brow and Ash Blonde towards the inner corner. I try to go extremely light-handed, and I make sure that I really buff that out big time with that spoolie, and then I will go in and shape it up. I always use a flat definer brush by Sigma. This is an E15 to shape this up with concealer, and I make sure that I do not use a concealer that's much lighter than my skin. That way it doesn't look unnatural. Then what I will do is take a little bit of just face powder. This is Mineralized Skin Finish in Medium Plus, and just dab it on the inner corner of my brows, and you'll see how that will lighten them up and not make them look as harsh. Then I will go in with MAC Cosmetics Indian Ink Eyeshadow. This is a pro color. I believe you can get it online though, or any pro store. This is such a gorgeous, matte, very pigmented, cool tone purple. I love it. So using an E15 from Sigma, I'm going to just put this on the entire lower lash line. I start on the outer corner, because I always want the outer corners of my eyes to be the darkest, because I think it's the most flattering. If you have to choose to have the darkness somewhere, I choose the outer corner. Then I will go in with Parfait Amour. This again is from MAC, and it is a lighter cool tone purple. So taking any pencil brush, I'm just going to buff that out all the way from inner corner to outer corner, back and forth. Make sure that you buff this out really, really well, because you do not want harsh lines underneath the eyes, because that's when it can look harsh. But if everything is buffed out, it will not look too intense or raccoon eyes. Then I'm gonna go in with a Makeup Geek foiled eyeshadow. This is in the shade Caitlyn Rose. So, so beautiful. And I just wanted to add this for an extra pop. These foiled eyeshadows are incredible. So just taking that same brush, I'm just going to dab Caitlyn Rose all over that lower lash line as well, just for a little bit more drama. Then I'm gonna highlight my brow bone using MAC Shroom, which is one of my all-time favorite brow highlights ever. It is a cool tone highlight, which is amazing. It works well on so many different skin tones. I used to always use this as a cheekbone highlight on tons of my clients, because it's just so gorgeous. So this is Shroom by MAC. Then I'm going to just coat my lower lashes with mascara. I couldn't really show you this because I get my forehead all up in the camera, but that's okay. You get the point. Then I'm going to contour using Makeup Forever Bronzer in number 20. There is a 10, a 20, and a 40, I believe. There's probably a 32. but I am using number 20, which is a little bit light, but I like it because I can be really heavy-handed and it doesn't look too dramatic. So that is why I stick with 20. And then I am using a rounded blush brush by Makeup Geek to contour. It is the perfect, most like tiny, stiffest brush ever for contouring. It's incredible. And then I will go in and blend everything out with the Morphe Brushes MB5 brush. And I'm just going to make sure that that contour is nice and stiff back by those ears, because that's where I like it to be sharp. I'm going to be mixing MAC Pink Swoon and Makeup Geek Rendezvous Blush. Rendezvous has a little bit more of a purple lilac tone in it, and I just felt like mixing it. This is totally unnecessary. Like, really, you can use whatever you please. But I just wanted to use a very cool tone, pinky, kind of purpley blush, because this will really complement the cool tones and the grays and the purples in our eyes. So I'm just blending that into the contour, working up towards the temples. And then I'm gonna go in with Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in the shade Luminous Light. I have re-fallen in love with this recently, and I have used it nonstop for the past couple of weeks. Using a tapered highlighting brush from Sigma, I'm just gonna put that on the top of my cheekbones, and then kind of just right on the center of that cheek as well, to give that blush a little bit of a glow. Then, to finish this off, I decided to go in with an eyeliner on my waterline. This is Ardency Inn Liner in the shade Dark Blue, but it just comes off as more of like a royally purple blue. It matched my lower lash line perfectly, so you can see how that looks. You could leave this blank, you could put black. Black would be very striking and very beautiful with this look, but I just wanted to do an entire purple lower lash line, so that is what I chose. I think that it looks so awesome. Then I'm going to go in with MAC Cosmetics Blankety Lipstick. I wanted to do something super nude. You can do whatever you please. I feel like lips are always a very personal choice as to how you choose to match it with your look. But I wanted to do a really nude lip color, and Blankety is kind of a gray, cool tone nude. Then I couldn't decide which facial spray I wanted to use. Today I was very indecisive. So we're going to just double fist it and go in with Urban Decay All Nighter and Urban Decay Chill Makeup Setting Spray. So that completes our look. And then after I got done curling my hair, I was like, wait, my lip is way too nude. So I decided to go in with Bite Beauty Lush Fruit Lip Gloss in the shade Peach, just to pinken up a little bit and help complement our face. So that completes our look, you guys. Happy New Year's. I love you so much. I'll see you in 2015. Have an amazing night, and I'll talk to you later.
Let's do this. I shaved my leg just for this video. Don't know why, but I did. What? What is that? What? No. What? 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 The vacuum cleaner just... No? Okay. Oh my God, it is 7:30 and I still have to take selfies. Okay, when the hair starts to go flat, that's when I know I'm done. What do you know? Nothing little hairspray can't fix. Ay caramba. I put some music on in this bitch. I'm not feeling it today. That was a sign from God to play my music.